Pastor Jason ලංකාවේ කෙනෙක් හැබැයි ඔහු පිලිපීනයේ රටේ ගිය හොස් අවුරුදු ගානකට ප්‍රථමයෙන් ඔහු එතන ඒ සේවයේ යෙදලා තිබෙනවා ඊට පස්සේ word for the world කියනවා විශාල වූ සභාවක ඔහු සේවය කරනවා පාලකවරයෙක් හැටියට ඔහුගේ සහෝදරය තමයි අපේ ලේක් සභාවට එන්නේ ඒ සහෝදරගේ මාන්නේ අපේ පාස් ජේසන් මහම්මුණා ගිය අවුරුද්දේ ඔහු ආවම ඔහු අපේ ලේක් සභාවට ඇවිල්ලා වචන වචනේ බෙදාගත්තා මම ඔහුට කිව්වා මම කොහෙට ඇවිල්ලා අපේ ප්‍රධාන සභාවේ ලබා ගන්න දෙවියන් වහන්සේ වචනේ ඉතින් වැඩි කාලයක් ගන්න නැතුව අපේ පාස් ජේසන්ට හොඳ අපෝස් සම්මාන දෙන්න අපි ගන්න
So if you don't know where the Philippines is, it's just if you go to China on the map and you look just below China, you will find the Philippines.
Philippines koi de kela danne naththam China kela baluwa de loka sidiyeme China palayan thiyena Philippines.
The Philippines, you will be surprised to know that the Philippines has 7,000 islands.
ඔබ පුදුම වෙයි සමහරකට පිලිපීනයේ දූපත් තියෙනවා 7000ක්
and I live on the main island of Luzon.
මේ Luzon කියන්නේ ප්‍රධාන දූපතේ තමයි මම ජීවත් වෙන්නේ.
And the city Manila is in Luzon.
මේ Manila කියනව අගනුවර තියෙන්නේ Luzon කියනා වූ දූපත පිටත.
I'm married to a Filipino girl.
මම ඒ පිලිපීන රටේ කෙනෙක් තමයි විවාහ වෙලා ඉන්නේ.
And we have three sons.
අපිට පුතාලා තුන්දෙනෙක් ඉන්නවා.
My eldest son is 16 years old.
මගේ වැඩිමහල් පුතාට අවුරුදු 16යි.
I was so impressed.
මම ඉතාමත්ම සතුටුලපත් වුණා.
I was watching the young boy playing the drums.
මම දැක්කේ තරුණ ළමයෙක්ගේ ඩ්‍රම් එක වාදනය කරනවා.
And I remembered my second son.
මගේ දෙවනි පුතා මට මතක් වුණා.
Who is about his size?
ඔහුගේ විතර ප්‍රමාණයක ඇති.
And I'm so amazed that the young children here are in the worship ministry, worshiping the Lord.
මම සතුටුයි මෙවැනි තරුණ ළමයින්ට අවස්ථාව දීලා තිබෙන නිසා දෙවියන් වහන්සේට නමස්කාර කරනවා.
I said, God has blessed your church so much. Through your children.
මම දකිනවා දෙවියන් වහන්සේ ඔබගේ ධර්මවත් තුළින් ඔබගේ සභාවට ආශිර්වාද කරනවා.
Can we give the Lord praise?
අපි ස්වාමීන් වහන්සේ ප්‍රශංසා කරමු.
I was also blessed by the many wonderful testimonies that we heard this morning.
ඒ වගේම මම ඔබට කියන්නම් මම ආශිර්වාද ලැබුවා ඒ සාක්ෂි ඔබගේ අහලා.
Truly the Lord is at work in our lives.
ඒකෝ අපි අනිවාර්යයෙන්ම ධර්මා දෙවියන් වහන්සේ අපේ ජීවිතේ ක්‍රියා කරන බව.
And I believe today
මා විශ්වාස කරනවා දවසේ
we are going to hear from God.
අපි දෙවියන් වහන්සේගේ පණිවිඩය අහන්න යනවා.
And I believe that somebody here
මා විශ්වාස කරනවා මෙතන ඉන්න යමෙක් අපි
needs to hear this message from the Lord.
මේ පණිවිඩය අහන්න අවශ්‍යකමක් ඉන්නවා මෙතන.
And I hope it encourages you and builds you up.
මම හිතනවා ඔබ ධෛර්යමත් වෙයි ඔබ ශක්තිමත් වෙයි කියලා.
Would you open your Bible with me to 1 Samuel?
ඔබගේ බයිබලයේ අනුනාද මාසමග 1 සාමුවෙල් පොතට
chapter 22
22 වෙනි පරිච්ඡේදයට
verses 1 and 2
22 අපි බලන්න යනවා 1යි 2යි.
We're just going to focus on these two verses this morning.
අපි මේ පද දෙක තමයි අපි බලන්න යන්නේ මේ උදෑසන.
I will read it in English and Pastor Parker will later read it in Sinhala.
අපි දැන් මේ වචනේ කියවන්න යනවා ඔබට.
David left Gath and escaped to the cave of Adullam. When his brothers and his father's household heard about it, they went down to him there. All those who were in distress or in debt or discontented gathered around him, and he became their leader, about 400 men were with him.
එවිට දාවිත් එතනින් ගැලවී ගොස් අදුලම්ගේ ගුහාවට පැමිණුණේය. ඔහුගේ සහෝදරයද ඔහුගේ පියාගේ පවුලේ සියල්ලෝද ඒ අසා එහි ඔහු ළඟට ගියෝය. විපතට පත් වූ සියල්ලෝද නරතුරු සැටි සියල්ලෝද නොසතුටු සිටි සියල්ලෝද ඔහු වෙත රැස් වූහ. ඔහු ඔහුගේ අධිපතියා විය. මෙසේ ඔහු සමග 400ක් පමණ මිනිස්සුෝ ඇති වූහ. අපි ප්‍රාර්ථනා කරමු.
Heavenly Father, we are so thankful for the wonderful privilege of being able to worship you this morning. We thank you for the salvation that we enjoy through your Son Jesus Christ. We thank you that through your Holy Spirit we are able to understand your word. Speak to your people this morning, Lord. May your anointing rest upon our hearts and minds. So we will be strengthened and empowered by your word. So that our lives will be changed. So that you will be glorified. In everything we do. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
The title of my message this morning to you is entitled The Wounded Healer. Do you know that we are all in some way or the other wounded healers? We all go through times of painful experiences. Like we heard this morning, many people are going through troubles. But in spite of those troubles, God has called us to minister to others who are in trouble. Do you believe that? Say amen. David was in trouble. A few chapters before this, David was anointed by Samuel. He was anointed to be king. The Holy Spirit came upon him. Later he killed the giant Goliath. He killed the giant Goliath with the power of the Lord. But then King Saul became jealous of him. Because when David went to battle with the Philistines, by his leadership he killed 10,000 of people. Whereas Saul had only killed 1,000. The people began to praise David for his leadership. And so Saul became jealous. Saul decided to kill David. David had to escape from Saul. David escaped to the wilderness. And here in this story we find that he comes to a cave called the cave of
Adullam.
David is in distress. David is trying to survive another day. And if you look at Psalm 63, you will see that it is a psalm that David wrote when he was in the wilderness. Let's just briefly look at Psalm 63. And this psalm he wrote when he was in hiding from Saul. He writes, O God, you are my God. Earnestly I seek you. My soul thirsts for you. My body longs for you. In a dry and weary land where there is no water. You see, when David was in distress, when David was in troubled time, when David was in hiding from a fierce enemy, he wrote this psalm and it reveals to us that in the midst of his trouble, he was in the best place that he could ever be. Because he was seeking the Lord
தேவிய பாசம் செவ்வாய் காலை
he says more than water or food
ஓகேனோ கேப வீமன வாடா
I need you Lord
மத ஓடி ஒவ வான்சேவாயே
my soul thirsts for you
மகே ஆமே ஒவ வான்சேனாய்கி பாச
my body longs for you
மகே முழு ശരീരமே ஆச கர்ப வான்சேவா
if this dry and weary land where there is no water
ஏ வதுர நதி மே வீடுனா உதேசே நாவின் கேனவா
so David here
மென தாவித்துமா
was in the prime of just trying to survive.
Oh man, komari hadanne ekak dawasak thama wedi puru jeevan wenna.
Trying to escape from trouble.
E thiyuna prashna wali berenna utsaha danuwa.
And I'm trying to imagine.
Dan mama hitanawa
what was David's prayer like to God?
David mona wage yaadnawa karanne thiyada liya mahanseta.
What do you pray when you are going to
pray? Obata prashna enawada mona kohomada yaadna karanne?
You know, we would usually pray, oh God, send us help.
Api dewa swami yaadna
Swami,
mage avashyathawen sampurna kavari yawanna.
And what kind of people did God send to David?
Habai deviyan wahanse David yawa mona wage minissuda?
And look at in verse 2.
Api dakinawa deweni pade.
In Samuel 22.
Eka Samuel 22 ke api kiyawa pade.
It says that all those
etara kiyawa siyalloma
all those who were in distress
ekiyanne vipadata patthuna awu aya
all in debt
ये वाक्य में नंतर नायकों से अधिकार
those who are discontented gathered around him
ये क्या मैं असल तरह पापन हुआ है
and he became their leader
ये आया दावी पाटे रोकूना दावी लोगों के अधिपति आऊँगा
if you are in trouble
ओबे प्रश्न है मैं देखना बना
if you are trying to survive in your own life
ओबे के जीवन दे गुड़े इतना उत्साह बना ना
would you like to be surrounded by these kind of people
ओबे आसान है मेरे वाक्य मिनिस्ट
people who are in debt
ek yanne nayakuru sathi minissu
people who are in distress
ek yanne jeevithe satunak nathi minissu
people who are discouraged
ek yanne hamathissema adahanawanthaya ida minissu
but these are the kind of people God sent to David
have I been David yawa sendaga me wage thama deviya mawase yawa sendaga
sometimes when we are in trouble
api samananata prashna nathi innakota
we cannot focus on helping others
apita ba anitha udaw karanna hithanna apita ba ape prashna lesa
api ekak felt like that
obata ema hithila thiyenawada kawadama
Yes.
Oh.
And I guess David would have felt that.
අනිවාර්යයෙන්ම ඩාවිඩ් අප් මේ වගේ හිතෙන්න ඇති.
I'm trying to survive.
අනේ ස්වාමී මමත් මේ ගොඩෙන්න හදනවා.
How can I help these people?
මම කොහොමද ස්වාමී අනිත්‍යයන්ට උදව් කරන්නේ මේ වගේ අවශ්‍යතාව තියෙන අයට?
But this is the situation God put David in.
හැබැයි දෙවියන් වහන්සේ ඩාවිඩ්ව දැම්මේ අන්න එතනටයි.
You know Jesus made a promise to us.
යේසුස් වහන්සේ අපිට පොරොන්දුවක් දුන්නා.
I could not take that promise in the morning.
මම ඒ පොරොන්දු උදේ කියන්නේ නැහැ.
But in the Gospel of John,
have you heard me put
it? He said, "In this world,
you will ask him, 'Where do we
go?' You will have trouble.
You will have a question at the end of it."
And trouble is a part of this life.
May happy jiva pena may jivi de prashna ni baar hai din yano.
But he also said, "Take heart."
Have I advanced to a shakti lavanna?
I have overcome.
The world. Mama may loke jayanta.
I want to tell you this morning.
Mama may udarsa abadi kila baar.
Be careful that you don't go into survival mode.
Oba nitam pathenna udhara pathenne ba.
Because that can hinder you from fulfilling your purpose.
Nitam pathenna minisu jivite parama.
God wants you to live the Christian life.
Devi and Mahasi ki naam kitu bhi mage jeevan penda.
In spite of the troubles that you face.
Oba monada mona mera prashne ka prashna hai.
There is always opportunity.
Oba ta avasthava tiyenawa.
To minister to somebody else.
Vena kaalahan sevaya karanna.
Even though you might go through trouble.
Oba prashna meda athi e vena kenek oba sevaya karanna.
You know one day somebody told me this story.
Ek kenek mata ekak avasthava me kathama kiwwa.
About a missionary who went to another country.
ඒ වෙන රටකට ගියා වූ මිෂනාරි සේවකයෙක් පිළිබඳව.
He went to a place in Africa.
ඔහු අප්‍රිකාවේ රටකට ගියා.
It was a very poor place.
ඒක හරි දුප්පත් රටක් තමයි.
And he had to live with 10 other missionaries.
ඔහුට තම මිෂනාරිවරුන් ඒ කියන්නේ සේවකයන් තව 10 දෙනෙක් එක්ක ජීවත් වෙන්න වුණා.
And they only had to eat once a day.
ඔහුට තිබුණේ මොන දවසකට එක කෑම වේලයි.
And so
ඒ නිසා
on the first day that he arrived there.
ඔහුගේ පළවෙනි දවසේ
And they served the food.
They came up into a.
And in the moment they prayed for the food,
we are not going to come and get it.
They all jumped on the food and got their food.
Oh, come on, panna, let me get up to it.
And this missionary,
may missionary be a.
Since it was his first day,
okay, panna, we are not going to.
And he did not know the situation.
Oh, let me get up to it.
there was no food left for him.
ඔහුට කිසිම කෑමක් දෙන්න කෙනෙක් නැහැ.
So he went to sleep hungry.
ඉතින් ඒ දවසේ පඩකින් නිින්දට ගියා.
And the next day when he woke up,
අනිත් දවසේ නැගිටාම
he was very very hungry.
දැන් ඔහුට ඉන්න බෑ පඩකින්.
And so he thought,
oh, හිතුවා
today I'll be prepared.
අද මම ලෑස්ති වෙලා ඉන්නවා.
And then it's time to eat.
කෑම කන වෙලාව ආවම
I will not close my eyes.
අද මම යාඥා කරනකොට ඇස් පහන් යන්නේ නැහැ.
I will be ready.
මම ලෑස්ති වෙලා ඉන්නවා.
So I will have some food.
එතකොට මට කෑම දෙන්න.
You see, he was in survival mode.
දැන් මම මොකද වැටුනේ? කැමෙන්ට් දෙන්නව මත්තනේ.
All he could think about is his own survival.
දැන් ඔව් එකම දේ හිතුවේ ඔව් කොහොමද ජීවත් වෙන්න කියලා.
So when the eating time came,
ඔන්න අපෝ කැමරේ දාලා
everybody began to pray.
ඔව් ඔක්කොමලා දැන් ඔන්න යාඥා කරනවා.
He kept his eyes open.
ඔව් නම් ඇස් පහන් යාඥා වේ. ඔය ඇස් කරන් ඉන්නවා.
And the moment they said amen, he chopped and got his food. And all the others were shocked. They said, why are you so in a hurry to get your food? He said, well, yesterday you were all in a hurry and had nothing to eat. And they said to him, no, today there is no hurry. Because today there are four people less. So there is plenty of food today. So you see, the lesson of the story, that when we are in survival mode, sometimes we cannot think of doing good to others. We only think of our own
survival.
But we are wounded healers. Because even though we are going through trouble, even though we are wounded ourselves, we are called to go and help others. We are called to reach out to others beyond ourselves. The world by nature is very selfish. People only care for themselves. But in the church of our Lord Jesus Christ, we must care for more than ourselves. We have to live, but we also have to help others. Do you believe that? Would you give God praise? It reveals to us what church should be like. That all the wounded people, all the discouraged people, those who had debts, those who were in trouble, they all came together. And the wonderful thing about the story, that if you look at several chapters later, that these people who were in trouble became David's mighty warriors. Do you believe that those who are in trouble can become mighty warriors for God?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know, there was a time I was going through some trouble myself. I was in financial trouble. My wife had to work. While I was going to Bible school, I had no job because I was preparing to be a pastor. We had our first son. He was about he's 16 years now, but he was just 1 year at that time. And so one time I was praying to God, Lord, I am in need. I need your help right now. Please send some help. And then the phone rang. And I thought,
මම හිතුවා
that maybe this is someone calling to help me
අනිවාර්යයෙන්ම මේකෙන් මට කවුරුද කියනවා ඇති මට උදව් කරන්න කියලා
and then I picked up the phone in excitement
මම හරි උද්‍යෝගයෙන් කියලා ෆෝන් එකට ආශ කරා
it was someone asking me for help
අන්න මේ ඒ ෆෝන් එක ගන්න එක මගේ උදව් වෙනවා
and he said we don't have anything to eat in the house
ඔන්න කියලා අනේ අපේ ගෙදර කන්දක් මොකුත් නැහැ
our children are hungry
අපේ ළමයි බඩගින්නේ ඉන්නේ
we don't have milk for our baby
අපේ දරුවන්ට මේ කිරි පිටිවක් නැහැ දෙන්න
please pastor can you help us
අනේ පාස්ටර් අපිට උදව් කරන්න
and I was thinking how can I help this guy when I myself am going to
poverty මං කොහොමද මෙයාට උදව් කරන්නේ මගේ තියෙන මේ ප්‍රශ්න කරදරම් මත
and so I realized
එතකොට මට තේරුම් ගියා
this is what Christianity is all about
ක්‍රිස්තියානි ධර්මය කියන්නේ මේකයි
so I got on my motorcycle
mage motorcycle nakala
and I went to his house
mage motorcycle gedata giilla
I got him food on the way
mama bawa camera tika halagena giilla
I gave the family the food
e camera tika pawulata diila
and then I gave him all the money I had in my wallet
ani mage thibuna saakka dunnathama salli dunna
later when I went to pick up my wife from work
mama ida passe giya mage baharaya ganna welapalen
I thought
mama hituwa
that maybe my wife has money
samada baharaya ganna sam salli athi
so I asked
Mama,
do you have a money?
Why don't you tell me, mother?
She asked me why.
Hey, give me any.
Because I gave all mine away.
Why give me money? Then I'll give mine to you.
And she said, No, I don't have.
I don't have a bag.
So that night,
ये रात में,
we went to sleep hungry.
इधर अभी क्या मैंने तो इधर करने किया.
While the family went to sleep full.
ये अनित पावल कहाँ ने इधर करना?
But praise God.
हमें देवियाँ मानसर प्रशंसा में बा.
We had an opportunity.
अभी आवश्यकता बत्ती बुना.
To glorify God.
देवियाँ मानसर गाउर बेदीना.
Despite our suffering.
आपे प्रश्न में द पावा.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen.
You know our Lord Jesus Christ.
आपे स्वामी
It says in the Word of God, in Isaiah, that by His stripes, we are healed. He suffered, so that we can be healed. And if we are going to be Christ-like, then we must understand.
අපි තේරුම් ගත යුතුයි
this is a part of the Christian life
ක්‍රිස්තියානි ජීවිතයේ මෙන්න මේ වගේ තමයි
that in spite of our suffering
අපිට ප්‍රීඩාවල් ප්‍රශ්න තියෙනවා
we are called to be healed
හැබැයි ඒත් අපි අන්නායව සුව කළ යුතුයි
amen
amen
hallelujah
hallelujah
today I want to give you three M's
මම අද ඔබට මේ ඉංග්‍රීසි භාෂාවෙන් එම්මක් වලින් පටන් ගන්නවා දේවල් තුනක් දැන් දැනවා
and these three M's we seek to practice in our church in the Philippines
අපේ පිලිපීනේ සභාවෙන් මේ එම්මක් වලින් පටන් ගන්නවා කාරණා තුන අපි කරනවා
if you are going to be effective for Christ
ඔබ ක්‍රිස්තුස් වහන්සේ උදෙසා බලපෑමක් කරනවා
if you are going to be productive as a Christian
ක්‍රිස්තියානි කෙනෙක් වශයෙන් ඔබ ඵලදරන්න යනවා නම්
and you are going to minister to others and bring them to the Lord
ඔබ අනිත්‍යයන් දීන සේවකල එල්ලම ගේන්න යනවා නම්
you need to practice these three M's
දෙන්නව ප්‍රතිපත්ති තුන අනුගමනය කරන්න
the first M
පළවෙනි මායන්නට M අකුර
is the word model
ඒ කියන්නේ ස්වરૂපය
people need to see your life
මිනිස්සුන් ඒ ස්වરૂපය ආකෘතිය දකින්න යුතුයි ඔබගේ ජීවිතේ
you see David in the cave of Adullam
David ඒ ගුහාවේ ඉන්න කල
he had a choice
David තෝරා ගැනීමක් තිබුණා
he could be discouraged and defeated by his problem
යාක තිබුණා යාගේ ප්‍රශ්න වලින් නැති වෙලා යන්න
but then he would be not effective to empower those people troubled people who came to
him හැබැයි යාගේ ප්‍රශ්න වල යා දුන්නා නම් ඡාය ගන්න යාට උදව් කරන්න බෑ ප්‍රශ්න වලින් ඉන්න මිනිස්සුන්ට
he has to model his faith to those
ඕක දැන් තියෙන හැදින පෙන්නන්න ඕනේ අනිත් අයට
you also have a choice in your life
ඔබටත් ඔබගේ ජීවිතේ තෝරා ගැනීමක් තියෙනවා
you can choose to be discouraged
ඔබට තෝරා ඔබට තෝරා ගන්න පුළුවන් අත්දරින්න.
You can choose to model your faith.
ඒ වෙලාවට ඔබට තෝරා ගන්න පුළුවන් ආකෘතියක් වගේ ලස්සන ස්වරූපයක් වගේ පෙනී සිටින්න ඔබගේ ඇදහිල්ල ගැන.
So when you face problems,
ඔබට ප්‍රශ්න ආවම,
in spite of grumbling, without grumbling,
කොබුරන්නේ නැතුව,
praise God.
දෙවියන් වහන්සේට ප්‍රශංසා කරන්න.
Model your faith.
ඔබගේ ඇදහිල්ල උදාහරණයක් වගේ පෙන්වන්න.
Say even though I have problems,
කියන්න මට ප්‍රශ්න තියෙනවා.
But I believe.
හැබැයි මම විශ්වාස කරනවා.
With God, all things are possible.
දෙවියන් වහන්සේට සියල්ල පුළුවන් කියලා.
Let the people around you see your faith.
ඔය මිනිස්සුන්ට ඔබගේ ඇදහිල්ල දකින්න ඉඩ දෙන්න. ඔබට ප්‍රශ්න තිබුණා.
Never let it stop you from being a good person.
ඔබ කෙනෙක් වෙන්නේ නතර වෙන්න දෙන්න එපා මේ ප්‍රශ්න නිසා.
Never let it stop you from doing the right thing.
ඔබ හරි දේ කරන්නේ නතර කරන්න එපා ඔබගේ ප්‍රශ්න නිසා.
Sometimes in the Philippines.
සමහර විට පිලිපීනයේ.
Many people say to me.
සමහර මිනිස්සු මට කියනවා.
God will understand.
ආ දෙවියන් වාසක තේරෙනවා.
Because I am going through these problems.
මම ප්‍රශ්න වැඩිනේ යන්නේ.
I have to compromise and disobey.
මට තියෙනවා සමාන කියලා ක්‍රිස්තියානි දේවල් නොකරන දේවල් මට කරන්න වෙනවා. මට අකීකරු වෙන්න වෙනවා මගේ ප්‍රශ්න නිසා.
You see, our problems are not an excuse to do the wrong thing.
අපේ ප්‍රශ්න නිදහසට කාරණාවක් නෙමෙයි වැරදි දේවල් කරන්න.
Our problems.
අපේ ප්‍රශ්න
should never
කවදාවත්
stop you from doing what is right.
අපිව නවත්තන්න හොඳට හොඳ දේ කරන එකෙන්.
Because even though you have problems. God's power,
දෙවියන් වහන්සේගේ බලය,
never changes.
වෙනස් වෙන්නේ නැහැ.
God is always powerful.
දෙවියන් වහන්සේ බලවත්යි.
He is always in control.
දෙවියන් වහන්සේ සෑම විටම පාලනය කරනවා දෙවියන් වහන්සේ.
Hallelujah. So we need to at all times model our faith
in the surround us. හැමතිස්සෙම අපේ වටේ ඉන්න අයට අපේ ඇදහිල්ල අපි පෙන්නන්න ඕනේ.
It's easy to talk about Christ.
Christmas වාචක ගැන කතා කරන්න ලේසි.
But the difficult part is to live.
අමාරු දේ තමයි ඔබ ක්‍රිස්තියානි කෙනෙක් වශයෙන් ජීවත් වෙන එක.
Amen.
Amen.
You see, just this year.
මේ අවුරුද්දේ.
Again, the Lord put me in a difficult situation.
ස්වාමි වහන්සේ මාව තව අමාරු තැනකට දැම්මා.
You see, I was going through in the beginning of the year. This year, I was going through a little bit of difficult time.
Mama, me how did you live? Mama, how did Tamay magi kamji?
And you know, for about 2 years, I have paid up and bought a brand new motorcycle.
How did you take it? Because Mama gave it up. Mama, alu bicycle, jatta motorcycle, jatta.
So I said to my wife,
Mama, magi baare ad kiwa.
Let's sell this motorcycle.
Happy me bicycle, vikuna.
So we can have the money to fix our problem.
Happy question, because we are not.
So one day I went to a retreat.
And then I saw Mama Dabasa got a gear.
With Christian leaders.
And now the Christian leaders samaga kala dabagana mama kiya.
There were many pastors from there in that retreat.
Itana bo palaguru evilla hitiya.
And we were about 4 pastors in one room.
Ape e kamare palaguru 4ak hitiya.
And there was a pastor next to me.
Ma mage yapathilu palaguru hitiya.
He was from the province, from a distant place.
So duru patthakin evilla ipu palaguru.
So when we were talking and praying.
Then ape kapagana api yapathana kene kiyana.
He asked me to pray for him.
Oh, you want him? What are you asking for?
He said, "Please pray that my wife and I will have a new motorcycle."
Oh, you want? Swami wants to know. You are asking for what? I am going to buy one. Alu motorcycle. Then you want to take it?
So while I was praying for him,
then what am I asking for? What is that?
It was in my heart.
My heart was that.
That the answer to his prayer.
Okay.
Is already with me.
Maadava dantama dina.
So why am I praying?
Then why mama yapna karanne?
So I stopped and said to him.
Mama nevadina kiwa uta.
I have a motorcycle.
Maadava motorcycle dina.
And I will give it to you at half the price.
Mama oyala denna eke mudale paageta.
And so you know, even and the guy said, okay, can I pay you in installments?
Oh, eka kiwa mama eka puluwanda kotas pasen obata gewanda.
So I said okay.
Maadava tamanne.
So I went home and I told my wife, this is what the Lord told us to do.
Swami wants after the key was a make
high. Initially she was shocked by it. Because we ourselves are having some problems. But you know, even though I told him to take it at half the price and then installments. Still I had no peace in my heart with that. As if God wanted me to do something different.
Swami wants me to do something different.
So the day the guy was coming to get the motorcycle, the Lord said,
Swami wants to give us
into my heart.
Mage hada wadata kiwe.
I want you to give it to him.
Nomile ne denna.
Don't sell it.
Vikunanne pa oy bicycle.
Give it to him.
Denna oda.
So I was thinking,
idi mama hituwa.
How will I solve my problem?
That's mage prashna visadanne kohomada mama.
And the Lord said to me,
deviyan wanse mata kiwa.
If you take care of him,
oba ogena balanda.
I'll take care of you.
Mama oba gena balanda.
You see, when we think of ourselves,
api gena hitana welawa me.
Sometimes we hinder God from
doing.
But if we focus on doing what God is calling
us to do,
then God can take care of
us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen.
It seems amazing. That this year, even though the year began bad for me, I was not planning to come here because I had not much money. But God solved all my problems. And I was able to come here and be with you. In spite of our problems, we need to model our. Amen.
Amen.
And I hope that you will never allow your problems to become a hindrance to you
serving.
The church needs to see that the world needs to see something different. You see, Christians are set apart for God. Jesus said in Matthew chapter 5, verse 14 to 16. Can you look at that for a minute? He said, "You are the light of the world. A city on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on its stand. And it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before men. That they may see your good deeds. And praise. So that everybody can receive the light. In the same way, your life is on display. And the way you live encourages others. That's why how David lived is so important in motivating those troubled people to be mighty warriors. The second M is the word mentoring.
Devani akura tamai ekeni upakara
teaching. Yeah. In the cave of Adullam, I believe that David began to teach these troubled people. You see, even in the Great Commission, in Matthew 28, verse 20, it says, teaching them to obey all things I have told you. And I believe that for them to become mighty warriors, David had to teach them to obey God. I believe that the power is in an obedient life. There is no reward in disobedience. But there is power in obedience. If you live your life in obedience to God, I believe the power of God will come upon you. There is a great anointing in the power in obedience. So in the church, in spite of our problems, we encourage each other to obey God. Our problems are never an excuse to disobey God. We need to obey Him because there is reward in obedience. Galatians 6 says, do not become weary in doing good. For in the proper time, you will reap a harvest.
Over the Honda Aswanak Lavinia.
If you don't give up.
Over Atarinata.
So don't give up.
Yeah, this Atarinata.
Tap the person next to you and say, don't give
up.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I don't know about the world. But one thing I know, that my God is faithful. And if I obey Him, and if I will not give up, my God will supply all my needs. He is faithful. He will give the harvest of the obedience. It's something that we should live by. Is the word mobilize. These people who came into this cave of
Adullam
eventually became mighty warriors. They became like David. And it's not enough that they bring people to fill the church. Our job in the church is to make them mighty warriors. Jesus said, go and make disciples.
Jesus wants you to go and
once we are filled with the Holy Spirit and we are built up in our faith and we are founded in our belief in God and we walk faithfully with Him, it's time for us to be mobilized to go and reach out to others. And so we are in the business of mobilizing people. So just as you are strong in your faith, you don't just come to church and go away. You need to look for someone to reach out. So that you can build them up. You can do for them what somebody did for you. And you can mobilize them into the world so that the many will come to know them. God's great plan is that the whole world will glorify Him. And for that purpose we need to build people up in their faith.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Do you believe this? And are you a part of this? I believe in God. Even though today you may be having problems, if you focus on God's plan, then God will take care of you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. This is what qualified David to be king. It says when you are trustworthy with little things, God, you become qualified to take care of big
things.
This was God's first test to prepare David to be king. That God gave him this small group of 400 people. Troubled people. And he says, if you can take care of them, and if you can make them mighty warriors, then you are ready to lead the nation. In the same way, what little things has God entrusted
you?
The people around you. Maybe that one friend that is in trouble. And God says, take care of them. If you care for the little things, you can be trusted with great things. And if you put your heart to it today, then greater things are coming your
way.
Do you believe
ඔබ විශ්වාස කරනවාද?
To give God praise.
අපි දෙවියන් වහන්සේට ප්‍රශංසා කරනවා.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.